Hello, everyone, and welcome to Chefs to Watch. This is the first one of the new year, and we have Liberty Rodgers, executive chef with Chartwells K-12 at Pembroke Pines Charter Schools in Florida. Welcome, Liberty.
Hi, thank you so much for having me.
Yeah, thank you for being here. And one thing that we always ask chefs to watch is kind of, you know, how did you get into this? And I found out that your first culinary job was at like a little vegetarian restaurant and you didn't know anything, but you learned knife skills there and like you just learned everything. So tell me about that restaurant. Where was it?
Absolutely. It was in Gainesville. It was called Ivy's Grill. It was a really, really wonderful place to be. It was a small, I'm going to say about 15 tables. I'm sorry. I'm trying to say seats, but it was about 15 tables. We were voted best breakfast in Gainesville a number of years in a row. And it was a great place to start. Chef Rick really, got down to the nitty gritty of taking each ingredient and making the best of it. You know, I really loved that. And it was a great place to start.
Yeah, very cool. And now that plant-based is such a big thing, it's like, that's a great foundation to come from.
Absolutely. Now, I will say they took it over from a vegetarian restaurant to more of a meat on the side. Because he definitely, when Chef Rick took it over, incorporated a bunch of the meat. But we still had that great vegetarian overlay that went throughout everything. It was wonderful.
Kind of like flexitarian, omnivore.
Absolutely. Body. Yes, yeah, absolutely.
I try to eat. I really do like that. And you've worked in like some other really interesting places too. You have been working in Disney World at one point. Tell me a little bit about that.
That was a lot of fun. I worked in the Living Seas restaurant, and what an amazing pace. And just being able to, we had to walk through the dining room to get to the kitchen, and it's the largest indoor aquarium, or it was at the time. I'm not sure if it still is. The largest indoor aquarium. So, I mean, just sea creatures floating by, and it was so beautiful. And just being part of Disney, you know, the culture that they create, and they really hone their customer service skills. And that's always top of mind for me, always focusing on our customers and making sure that they have the best. And Disney really helped me hone that.
Oh, yeah, that's a big deal at Disney. And like, it seems like anytime that I meet, especially pastry chef students in training, they're like, you could go around the room and all of their goal is like, I want to work at Disney World. I want to work at Disney World. Cause it's, they do such awesome things with the confections too. And there's so many like iconic, but like Absolutely. You said with the customer service, like it really is something. And I remember something I read a while ago, like where they, when they have, and they don't call them employee, they're cast members who work there. And if you were like in a princess costume and you see like a piece of litter on the ground, when you pick it up, you have to pick it up like with a flourish, like you have to go. And so it's not like it's, and I started doing that at home and it really does, like it kind of changes your attitude. I'm just like, I'm a princess.
Princess picking up garbage. Yes, they absolutely, it's on stage and backstage. Okay. And I had a great experience there. Actually, I saw a little child drop their popcorn bucket and I got to immediately say, let me take that for you. I got him another popcorn, and it was just, that's encouraged. I even got a pat on the back from my managers for it. And just the idea of really focusing on the customers and their experience. It's, you know, we got to bring the magic of Disney every time we stepped on stage, and it was really amazing. And even backstage, getting to, you know, bring food to the table, incorporating magic and hidden Mickeys in the sour creams, and, you know, everywhere we could add a little touch was amazing.
I love that. How fun. So, and then working with kids kind of, it, that helps with that too, because they love the fun.
Absolutely.
And then in between there, it's another place. I'm so fascinated by your career. Like, you worked at Cheesecake Factory, which is known to everyone by the extensive menu and how crazy it is. And I met a corporate chef from there a while ago, and he was like telling me that it's all about taking the ingredients. Like, you, there aren't really like a ton of different ingredients, but it's just all the different things you can do with them. So like, how was that?
You know, I loved my experience at the Cheesecake Factory. I worked down mostly with salads and pizzas and sandwiches, and learning how to make 20 Thai wraps that are on a plate this big when my station was just double that size in 7 minutes was a real treat and challenge. But honestly, my favorite part of that, besides the relationships that I made with wonderful people, I would go back to the saucier because they make all their own sauces at Cheesecake Factory, which they don't always do at TGI Fridays, which I worked at, and Chili's. But the saucier,
not coming out of a bag. They're actually making it back there.
That's exactly right. They make all their sauces and their dressings right there. I got to help the saucier and really learn even more about that. And it was such a wonderful place to be. And you know, anytime I can soak up more knowledge, I'm just thrilled to do that.
Totally. I just think that's so cool that you've done a couple things and now here you are in K-12 world. And
yes.
I wanted to see, how has it been going? How did you guys fare in your district, like through the continuing pandemic? Like, how have you guys been doing?
It's been quite challenging, but I'm really impressed. You know, of course there's supply chain issues and we're always running into, you know, last minute changes whenever at certain times, but you know, there's been a lot of work behind the scenes and we've been really planning way ahead. And the more we plan ahead, the easier it is to make it a seamless opportunity for the students. So hopefully they don't see our challenges as much. And every once in a while, we have to do a quick menu change. But for the most part, we menu out far enough and we've been really working to make sure we have everything on hand before we let them know what the menu is. Therefore, we don't have to change it as much. It's really been a challenge, but also watching the community get to come together has been really, really great. I have to say for the summer, we got to do hand out meals and we did bags. We did 2-3 day and 4 day bags. And we got to make individualized portions of some of the kids' favorites. You know, the arroz con pollo goes really well around here. They absolutely love that. And, you know, meatballs and mac and cheese. And we would put it in individual portions and we'd put them all together with everything you need for a meal. And I got to talk to some of the parents that would drive up and receive the meals. And they were so thankful and so grateful to get the time taken from them because they were like, it's one less thing I have to worry about. Yeah. You know, I don't have to think, what am I going to do for lunch? It's right there. I've got a menu. They may have gone out of sync for a little bit, but they always had what they needed. They could, you know, throw it in the microwave or throw it in the oven or however they wanted to take care of it. We gave them all the directions. And it was really, they were just so grateful and so thankful to have at least one thing taken off their plate. You know, we have a large variety of students here. And while some people really needed the help, others didn't need the help as much, but we're just grateful to have it, you know? So it really ran the gamut and it was wonderful to be able to support the families that we love so much.
That's so cool. Yeah. So many parents and caregivers, it's like you said, it's like just so many things on your plate at the same time. And especially, you know, with childcare, there's all sorts of things going on with that too. It's hard to do that. And it's awesome that like the USDA has made it easier for school districts to do this with, I think it's called Seamless Summer. Like I think that's
correct.
Thing because you're able to, and like the go bags seem like a really good way to get that done.
Yes, it was a really great way to not have to come by every single day. You know, that could have become a real hassle for parents who were, especially a lot of them are working from home and they can't get by. They, you know, it was hard for some of them to even come out. We got to see a lot of the kids because they were in the back seat. And it was great. And I got to ask them, you know, what was your favorite thing? You know, what do you want to see more of? So anytime I can get feedback from the community, from the kids, I'm always happy to take that in.
Totally. And you mentioned the arroz con pollo did really well. What were some other menu items that just kind of really stood out?
Well, kids' favorites, chicken nuggets, chicken tenders, chicken patties. I mean, those are kind of always great. They loved our meatballs, macaroni and cheese, the arroz con pollo. And we also do an Asian stir fry, chicken stir fry, nice. Which they really responded well to. So you know, a little bit of kids' favorites and a little bit of the parents' favorites, I think. But it really worked out. So the kids got to try new things.
Nice, nice. And a lot of that stuff that you're describing seems like it would just translate so well to bowls and like travel well, like clamshell or whatever it may be.
That was exactly the things we had to think about, you know, putting it in. We put them in individual bowls that they could literally reheat in the bowl, in the microwave. Right. So they didn't have to break things apart. And, you know, it was very, we tried to make it user friendly. Yeah. So they could, you know, just grab something, throw it in the microwave or throw it on the stove and have it heated up while they're doing their job over here. And then coming back to try and help their student, you know.
It's a struggle. It's a struggle for sure. And it's awesome that you're able to help. So, and obviously being back in school is what every parent and deep down every kid, they want to be back in school too. So has that been kind of happening like this, the past like fall semester, like getting a little bit
Yes.
normal?
Yes. Here in Florida, we're doing, you know, we've been in school and we're doing, we're doing really well with that. It's nice to have the kids back. They're happy to be back and see their friends and, mm-hmm. you know, all of that. And, you know, I'm sure it makes it a little bit easier on the parents. Mm-hmm. And yeah, for me, just getting to see the students again is such a wonderful release. You know, I really like, you know, getting to hear from them and see them and know that they're, you know, eating the food and loving it.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. So what are some things that you have planned like for this coming year, like menu items or things that like might be trends that your kids are looking at?
So what we've noticed really is kids are really culturally aware, and we're throwing in a few new cultural items. Now we've got, I believe it's Noodle Revolution. Revolution Noodle is one of the ideas that we have brought forth. And it's really kind of like a pho station where it's very customizable. It's broths, it's the traditional soba noodles. So it's really going to a traditional place of that. And we find that the kids really love anything customizable. Anything, can I put this in? Can I leave that out? Oh, I don't like that piece, but can I try that? And we got to, at our high school, be one of the premier places to do mac and cheeseology, which was really fun, where it's mac and cheese at the base. And then we had a few different themed days. So we did like a Mexican day, which was black beans and corn and turkey taco meat and chicken taco meat. And we got to put that on top of the mac and cheese, and they loved it. For Italian Day, we had Alfredo instead of the traditional cheddar cheese. And I'll tell you what, these kids went crazy for our roasted balsamic tomatoes to put on top of it. And we did a nice sausage crumble, and it was really wonderful. And we did a fresh pesto drizzle. And I tell you, first of all, it was great training for the staff. They got to make a new sauce from scratch. And everyone went crazy for it. Now they're trying, now the kids are like, can we have that pesto sauce back again? They're like, well, you know, let's get another Alfredo day. We'll get there. We can't make it every day, but that, you know, I love that, that they were really getting involved and seeing the different flavors. They would try new veggies that they wouldn't have tried. If we put balsamic roasted tomatoes just out next to something, they would, I'm not sure about that. But when you give it to them with something that they love already, oh, just try this on top of it, they're more likely to indulge and check it out and see what it's about. And some kids honestly just said, I'll just take the mac and cheese, please. And that was fine, but the customization gave them that opportunity.
That would be my daughter. She's plain. Everything is plain as can be.
That's totally fine. I love a good mac and cheese all by itself.
Absolutely. And it just seems like you're really connecting with them. That's so awesome. I really like the sound of that.
That's my favorite part of being in K-12 is getting to connect with the students, you know. And I've got to say, my team, they really have their fingers on the pulse of the students. And they're really good at letting me know what the kids are asking for, what didn't go over so well, what they're looking towards. And so I'm just so grateful to work with an amazing team of people that that really put their all into it. And everyone's focus is the kids.
For sure. That's what's so special about this line of work. That is unlike any other, for sure.
Absolutely.
And speaking of cultural awareness, I see that you were appointed to the Compass Education Diversity and Inclusion Committee. So I wonder if you could tell us a little bit about that. What does that entail?
Oh, I'm thrilled that you asked. Thank you. Well, diversity is really baked into everything in Compass Group. In fact, it's the reason I chose this to work with Chartwells over anyone else. When I was searching for better work-life balance. Mm-hmm. And they had sexual orientation and I believe gender identity in their representation, non-discrimination, mm-hmm. Long before anyone, that was even a thought in a lot of people's minds. And you know, the reason I came to K-12 was because I was catering and my wife was a teacher, right? And she worked Monday through Friday and had weekends off and had the holidays off. And what did I do? My longest days were Christmas and New Year's and all the holidays and all the weekends, and I'm working nights. Oh. So to find a way to get on the same schedule with her was really trying in the culinary world. So I got the opportunity. It was actually her cousin, thank you, Heidi, that told me, why don't you go look at schools, they have to feed people. And I was like, okay. So when I researched and I found Compass Group and Chartwells, I was so grateful that it meant so much to them. Right. And now having the opportunity to really help the company go into action with some of these ideas and really let people bring their entire selves to work. Mm-hmm. It's so important to me. You know, we celebrate all the holidays, you know, not just Christmas, but we sell, you know, Hanukkah and Diwali, and we bring everything we can in and we listen to people. That's been one of my favorite things since being on the diversity committee. It's getting to listen to people in that frame of reference. Mm-hmm. And really learn and understand more about people as a whole. Yeah. And I feel like when people can bring their whole selves to work, everyone works better.
Yeah.
Diversity is the bedrock, I think, of what makes places greater, you know, companies, homes, everywhere. If we can embrace each other for being different and find out about our differences and learn about them.
So true.
Open format, it's one of my favorite things.
Yeah, and it's good to hear that a giant company like Compass is invested in this, because that truly can help move the needle when it's, you know, so many employees worldwide. So that is a good thing, definitely.
It's been an absolute blessing. I've been on it for about a year and we're really making progress. Oh. So it's wonderful.
Yeah,
thank you for asking.
I liked how you brought out kind of like the listening aspect of it, because I think that's so important, is just listening to other perspectives, just somebody else's experience, because you don't know, you're not in somebody else's shoes. So I love the idea of communication and being able to talk about stuff and not being afraid to talk about it. So,
yeah, listening with empathy, listening to make sure that, you know, people feel heard instead of just listening to respond. Makes a big difference.
Oh my gosh, that's so true. Like in conversations, just with everybody could do better. That's something I constantly remind myself about. Mm-hmm. And being a good listener, it's like everybody could work on it. We all should keep on working. So I wanted to ask you too, in your Florida life, are there any fun facts about you that might surprise us? Like, do you have a pet alligator or?
You know me. Oh my gosh. No, I do not have a pet alligator. I do have three dogs and three cats. Yes, we have quite the menagerie at the house. I love that I can wear flip-flops every day of the year in Florida. That's wonderful. Something else, you know, I've always had a job in food since I was, I'm going to say 14 years old, but I did take a moment off to become a massage therapist. And I did that for a number of years and came right back to food. My heart's here. So some would call me the perfect wife because I can cook and massage, but don't ask my wife, please.
Yeah. It sounds pretty perfect though. Absolutely. And that tells me that, like, ergonomically, like, cooking too, like, you're conscious, you're doing the right stuff. And
that's exactly right. And I go through to all of my accounts, and I make sure everyone likes to reach and reach and reach. And I'm like, no, no, pull that back, push this over here. If you do this, look up, and every 10 minutes, do one of these, start looking up. I, you know, I definitely am more body aware than most.
Yeah. Yeah. It's those repetitive motions too, that do it to people. And that's
exactly right.
It's very physical work. It's very tough work. And we are so proud that you're doing it though. Thank you for all you're doing for the kids, and congrats on being our chef to watch.
Thank you so much. I appreciate you.